Hello and welcome to BusyWorksBeats.com. Today we continue the artist series right here at BusyWorksBeats.com/BeatMagic. Today we're going to focus on West Side Gunn and the style of Benny the Butcher. And this, I might separate the videos, but I love the sound of Conway, Benny the Butcher, 38 Special, West Side Gunn. I fell in love with the Griselda sound. I don't know who exactly is in the group, but man, I fell in love with their albums. And I think it's because of Jim Jones' album early in the year, called El Capo. So that's, man, I just fell in love with the New York sound. It made me love sampling all over again in a completely different way. I even found on Tracklib's website, they have a rhythm roulette built into the website to where it shuffles the tracks for you. So once I get more information from someone over at the team, I'm going to see how the licensing stuff works. And if it makes sense, we can put it on YouTube and make a whole series through rhythm roulette and Tracklib and Mass Appeal. So shout out to them. Anyway, thumbs up the video if you like this series so far, the artist series at BusyWorksBeats.com/BeatMagic. Today, again, we're going to focus on the West Side Gunn. I probably picked the wrong cover for West Side, but man, I just love his sound. So until I get the actual samples from Tracklib, we're going to use some of my friend's samples in Sound Oracle's folder. I like to go in his folder for like loops and sounds. So under, what is this? The No Games pack, under loops and samples, I found one that sounds pretty New Yorkish. Let's add this to the playlist. I don't know where it goes. Oh, also, the key is having a WWF or like a wrestling vocal in the background. So let me clean this one up real quick, add that as an intro, and then we'll drop it into the sample. So let's add an EQ. Let's cut out the lows. You see all those subs we don't need? You steal. And you could be fancy, add reverbs and all this. We're not going to mess with the mixing just yet. Let's add the sample into the playlist. And the first thing we need to do is count out the music. So it's 1, 2, let me turn this down. 1, 2, 3, 4, 2, 2, 3, 4, and now keep in mind, we don't have the stems, I don't think, at least from what I can see. 1, 2, 3, 4, 2, 2, 3, 4, and let's hit, whoops, grab our slice tool, hit shift alt, left click. All right, 1, 2, 3, 4, 2, 2, 3, 4, and boom. So this is at 79 BPM. We're not going to worry about the BPM right now. We're just going to click on audio clips, go to stretch mode, zoom in with your mouse, hit alt, left click just to drag it inside of anything that's rounded to whatever you count it to. So in this case, we counted, what, 2 bars? So I'm counting the 4 because we're in double time. You don't have to know what any of that means. Just time stretch it to the next bar thing, okay? Take it off stretch mode, and we are going to knock the tempo back down to, let's try like 91, maybe 84 to start out with. Okay, so it's going to keep its same length, so we don't have to worry about that. Now it's going to be half the speed, so let's go to stretch mode real quick. Go back to bar, just drag it in. So let me kind of do my DJ thing as if we're DJing. So I'm going to hit shift, duplicate it over. Just duplicate it, and then at the end you want to change it up, do that 4 thing, and let's just repeat this. Now we can get fancy later on, but we just need a structure. Now you can turn on your metronome. Now it seems like it already has reverb. What I'm going to do is just cut out a little bit of the low end. It's okay to leave in your low end. That's what I love about their sound, is that they leave all the flaws. Sometimes they pan a sample all the way to the right. Oh man, it's just, I love hip hop all over again. So let me see what panning this sounds like. Let's pan it like to the right, and let's do something different. So let's open up Omnisphere for a trillion bass. You could load up trillion or I'm actually trying to think. Let's load up trillion because we could, do I need Omnisphere? Let's just do Trillion for now. So Trillion's gonna give you that electric bass sound. So we are going to go to bass instruments, and let's go to electric fingered bass and click on just a regular bass. I don't know the difference between all the bass guitars. It's just a tone thing probably, but I'm sure if you go old school, it might sound maybe more, let's do full range old school. Let's just keep it like, the more flaw, the better. That's how I'm thinking right now. All right, so let's pan the sample to the right, and let's take out some of the low end just so it's not going going to give us a headache. It's okay to have a muddy mix. Like, sometimes their vocals are so low in the track and the beat is just way higher. It just makes you love, like, Flaw. Man, I just love their sound. Like, I can't stop talking about it because I'm obsessed with it now. Now, I don't know any songs. I just added, like, 20 songs to the playlist. So let's do something weird and unorthodox, which is pan the bass to the left. I forgot that's our vocal track, so let's route this to track 3. And I'm just going to freestyle the bass with my left hand. Boom, boom, boom. So let's record notes and automation to the metronome 1, as if we're playing a live bass. That was a bad one. Doesn't matter though. Now, luckily we're playing in MIDI so we can fix a couple things. I'm going to leave the timing because that's what makes it cool. Now one of these notes got a little too loud, so I think it was this one right here. And let's pan the bass to the left. So you're like, the bass to the left? What? I know, but if you hear their music, it sounds so crazy good. Because they're mimicking the mixing back in the 60s and 70s. They would literally pan like vocalists to the left or right, and the drums hard left. That's what I love about like back in the day. It wasn't so clean and pristine. Oh, synth.
You steal from Razor Ramon. You rip off the bad guy.
And what I might do is add a bad guy, and add like a delay, so it carries. So let's try that.
You,
and then let's right click, create automation clip, and let's turn it on right where he says bad guy.
Bad guy.
Let's do it the other way around, I'll do it backwards.
Bad guy.
And now it's on beat with the delay. And people can kind of sync up the sample with the
and
you can even use a crowd like as a part of the sample. Even I didn't think about that. You could chop this little thing right here and just use that at, let's do that actually.
Bad guy.
So let's hit shift left click, just cut that out. Duplicate this over and just hit alt to time align it with the grid and just. Now, the only thing is you would have to probably EQ it separate. So what I would do is just make this unique as a sample. But what we're going to do is just make it unique, period. So we don't have to open up any explorers or anything. And you could even try experimenting with time shifting. So let's hit Alt, left click, and time drag that out under time stretch. That's a time shift by itself. And that way it's more of a... Now let's go to mode, go to stretch mode. So it keeps its original tone. And that could just be like your background subtle thing that's just there. Just turn it down though. So let's route this to a new mixer insert. Let's go to 4, cut out the lows. And just turn it down. Just so it has like a texture to it, like a feels dated and grimy. Let's find some drums. So again, modern drums aren't going to have that sound. So let's go to some Illmind drums. I bought everything from Illmind when he had his sale. So shout out to Illmind. Let's go to Illmind Blap Kit. I'm picking random blap kits. We don't want any claps. I want like either drum breaks or just a kick and a snare. Now I've noticed a lot of their tracks don't have hi-hats. Now, I like this drum, so let's go to Slice X and drag this drum break in. And it's gonna auto slice the drums for you, so you don't have to waste your time doing that. And whoops, didn't mean to do that. Move to a new pattern, and all I'm going to do is just draw in drums because I want to hear the individual drum sound. So let's go to the piano roll. So that's a kick and a crash, hi-hat, kick, snare. Only thing with these, you have to know how to sample because I like this kick. So Let me show you a couple things. So with Slice X, you have to draw out the note length or else it will just cut itself off. Okay, now with real drums, here's another trick. We have to go to the channel rack and turn up the swing. Oh, you know what? I'm triplet timing. Let's zoom in a bit so we can see. Let's go to 1/4 because I forgot we're in a regular BPM now. Okay, so the drum breaks are going to be loops as if we're looping it. Okay, so notice all those little gaps add to the groove. Now it's a little too on the grid, so here's a trick. Grab your kick, that rhyme. Hit Alt right a couple times. No. And that stop and go effect makes it feel like it's sampled, so that we needed that sound. Shout out to Ilmon. Now the hardest part is going to be getting your drums to sound real. And that's why I said you want to go for more drum breaks, more acoustic drums, not those trap drums. You want to go for real drum sounds, like Ilmon stuff. Sound Oracle, I think, has some acoustic based drums in there. You can even swap it out if you need more punch. But their sound is not about the super punchiest drums. It's about the vibe. And this has that vibe. All right, so let's figure out where we are.
You steal from.
So what I'm going to have to do here is fit this whole vocal thing within that 4 bars. So let's go to the audio tab. Excuse me, go to stretch mode. And let me see if I could do this. Hit Control Z. Shouldn't have stretched it that way. Let's hit, I'm trying to think of how we could do this. Let's stretch the left side first. I don't want to mess with this side. We can always grab that later. I forgot we added that slice anyway. That technically that wasn't supposed to be slice. So anyway, hit Alt, left click, drag this within. Now we have to reveal the other portion here that we had.
You steal from the bad guy.
And all we have to do now is just move this delay automation over 1 bar.
The bad guy.
Sounds cool. I actually kind of like it squealed up like that.
You steal from Razor Flower. You.
But if you wanted the original pitch, you would go to channel settings, change your mode to stretch mode.
You.
But I kind of liked it the way it was. You steal from Razor Ramon.
You steal.
I like that tone.
From Razor Flower. You.
Let's add a little reverb to the sample, just so it feels like more eerie.
You.
Let's go to a blank track. Now again, when you're doing this kind of sample feel, to get the original sound, you're going to have to do a lot of work. I'm just being honest with you. A simple Fruity Reverb 2 is not going to give you that sample sound all the time. Maybe try Convolution Reverbs. I don't know all the ones on the market. I just know that this reverb has real spaces recorded, so it sounds like stuff's really in a space. So let's go to a concert hall. Let's click on something random. And there is a difference in tone because this... I don't want to get into everything about everything, but again, there's a lot of work that goes into sample making.
You steal from Razor Flower. You rip off the bad guy.
And here's where we can drop the
you.
So we might need to kick this a little more.
The bad guy.
So what I'll do is take that first kick and try and find a different kick, because that's more of a ghost kick. Here's the original. Let's try the one with the crash.
The bad guy.
But But see, the timing's different on a sample. It's probably like a little, if you go into the slice X, and what is this, marker 9? So if you go in, find marker 9, like zoom in with your mouse wheel, you can see that little time gap. Slice that out. But it's going to remap just like it did here. Hit Control Z to get rid of that.
The bad guy. Bad guy.
See where our drums sit. So that first kick is a little too delayed. There we go. And you can see this is not perfectly on the downbeat. You can see that slice has a little gap before it hits the transient. You could even move your sample a little to the left if you have to. Now, if you really want to get crazy, you could pan your drums to one side. Now, I wouldn't suggest it because we have the bass pan to the left and it doesn't hurt our ear. Now, what you could do is pan the drums to the right, but you have to be careful with the bass. You could have the vocal centered, but it's, I don't want to tell you what to do, but you can even pan your kick left, snare right. Let's just see what that would sound like. I'm just curious. If I can find the pan, where's the pan not bad? Interesting sound. So I know there's so many rules. People told you, oh, pan your kick mono. No, like those records in the 60s did not always have their drums pan centered. They had them pan left. I feel like the snare's a little pitchy. Let's pitch it down a little bit. You could even add a low pass filter. We're not going to get into everything about everything about everything about everything, but your resonance down, turn the LP on 1. Actually, that's going to affect everything. So let's go to articulator 2, turn it on 1, turn your resonance down, and go back to your snare, send it to the filter 2, and then you can mess with the cutoff. Even if your snare is too long, you can turn on the envelope for your volume. We're on articulator 2, so we have to tell it to go to 2. And that way you can shorten out the snare. It's just too bright. That way it's not distracting. I feel like it needs something else just to lift it up a bit.
You.
Probably just this vocal, really.
You steal from Razor Flower.
I don't know if he said anything cooler after this. Let's drag it out and see if he says anything cooler. I don't think he says anything cooler. He talks about like his gold chain or something after that.
Do you know how long and hard I work to buy
this gold?
This precious gold? How dear?
It's just too like, he's not saying anything, I don't think. I can't remember. Let me slide through all this stuff.
Do you know, tax man, what a guy like me can do to a guy like you? All right.
It would have been so much cooler if he said like that faster. I like it, but it might be too many syllables. Anyway, let's just add this section over here. It does need something just to like lift it up a little bit, maybe. I don't know.
Do you know, tax man?
Maybe just turning the bass up.
What a guy like me can do to a guy like you. All right.
We say no problem. You want a title match?
Wait, how'd I get...
Do you know who to a guy like you? Guy like you, like you, like you.
Oh, not the like you. That doesn't sound cool. Just the you part.
To a guy like you, like you.
I don't know how to perfectly get it to focus on the U, but that'd be sick.
Guy like you, like you, like you.
Let's just do it like that. I think think this is the drums. Maybe I added too much of a filter.
You steal from Razor Flower.
Yeah, we need that brightness of the snare, or else it kind of just dulls the sound out too much. Maybe something like a bass change up. So right here, I'll do 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 do. I'm just gonna draw this in to save time.
Do you know, tax man, what a guy like me can do to a guy?
Yeah, this is the reverb.
Do you know, tax man, like you, like you, like you?
Let me get that you part right, because that's so important. Like you. We have to line it up so it just starts. I'm just guessing right now.
No.
There we go. Okay, so it was the timing of the delay. That was the issue.
No.
Hear it in context.
Like me can do to a guy like you.
All right, it's a little too early, so we either have to offset the timing with smoothing or offset, or we have to manually move the automation to the right a little bit.
Like me can do to a guy like you. Like me can do to a guy like you.
Close enough. Again, we could obsess here all day long. And I'll mix it. I'll see if I can add a vocal to it. His vocals are kind of like two octaves above mine.
You steal.
And I still have to study each individual person because I don't know who's who. So I might just add like a random New York style verse to it. Right now it just needs a verse and it needs to be mixed a little bit. You can even add like pseudo vinyl crackle over it. So for example, you would go into RC20. I can't think of anything that adds vinyl crackle. Isotope Vinyl May. I can't remember. Where are we at? RC20. And just to add like a something over here, change the tone, pull it down. We're gonna take off any wobbling effect.
You steal.
Cut off the EQ as well.
You steal from Razor Flower.
Again, the goal is to make it sound like it's flawed.
You steal from Razor Flower.
I might just pan the kick to the right. Let me see what it sounds like. It even sounds different pan to the right.
I don't know.
So to balance this out, I'm really debating what I want to do with the drums. What I'm going to do right now is just pan it back to the center and just pan it in the mixer versus the inside the plugin. Because I'm really debating if we should have it pan to the right or left. I do like that left-right sound, but I just can't pick one.
You steal.
They get the most impact in the center. And we lose some characters when you pan it, but it still sounds good. Let's just keep it centered for now. So this is from Native Instruments. This is just gonna focus on the transient, make it a little bit pointier for you. Now if the sample drags out too long, you can pull it back in sustain so it shortens the drums. Feels like it has the most groove to it. You can always, this negative 42, you can always make it longer if you wanted the drums to sound a little bit bigger. I mean, that's a cool sound too. There's no wrong one. That's like the shorter sound, negative 42. Let's run them through a soft clipper. Turn the threshold up, go back to transient master. I don't know what their limiter sounds like, so I'm gonna turn that off. And now you can push the gain, okay, and then turn your fader down. This will bring the life out of your drums a little bit more. push them harder than 6 dB, maybe if you wanted to push them harder, what you would do is add an EQ and just turn this knob up. But it's not all about hard drums all the time. Everything is not a trap beat. But now you can feel the drums a little bit more. A little more in your face. I like this sound a lot better. I also would like if the drums had a little more reverb. Again, you would need something like high-end reverb or convolution reverb. Let's do reverb drums. And let me go to studio recording. And usually the smaller studios sound better for drums. So I would go to ascending and then just pick anything. So I'm just gonna pick anything there. And send the drums here, left click send. And it's sending a duplicate of the drums to this reverb track. It just makes the drums bigger and they feel real when you add this reverb to it. And depending on the room, it gives a little bit more bass to it. There we go. Yeah, that pulled me in a lot more. Something about this, it's like a double hit. And again, at the end, you could just spice it up a little bit. Maybe go to beat mode, turn this shorter, and just hit shift, just duplicate. And just kind of make it stutter. We go to one half beat. I can't really see from back here.
Do you know, tax man, what a guy like me can do? To a guy like you.
So let's hear it without looking at the beat, just so we're not influenced by sliders and stuff that's moving around. And I'll mix it a little bit. I'll probably go back and add vocals. Probably not exactly sounding like Westside, because his voice is like an octave higher than me. And I have to really listen to
it. You steal from Razor Flower. You rip off the bad guy. What a guy like me can do to a guy like you.
Man, I can't wait to continue this series. I'm so excited. Again, I'll try and go back and add lyrics in the mind of West Side Gunn and Conway and Benny the Butcher. They're all, like, combined, they're amazing. Shout out to Griselda and everybody involved. Thank you for Joe Budden for even putting me on the Joe Budden podcast, to that whole group, because the sound is amazing. So let's get into more sample beats. It's BusyWorksBeats.com. Please like the video so we can help more producers around the world. If you like this series, it really does matter. Thank